Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Zeanex AR. In this video, we will show you how to display multiple images on an image target. So let's get into it. Opening a new project, name it Career Project. Now delete the main camera, add AR camera and image. Now switch the platform to Android or iOS. Go to build settings. I am making it for Android. Switch platform. Now as you can see this warning sign, so you have to enable vuforia from player settings. Make sure to check vuforia augmented reality. Now go back. Now we have to add an image target. An AR license key. Now open the vuforia portal and make sure you are signed in and go to develop. Click on get development key. Name it. Click this checkbox, confirm. Open it and copy it by simply pressing on it. Now go back to Unity. Click on AR camera. Click on open vuforia engine configuration and paste the license key here. Now go back to vuforia online portal. Go to target manager. Add database. Name it. Create. Open it. Add a image target on which you have to show multiple images. I am adding the target. Single image. Give any width, name it, add. Now download this database, make sure the status is active. Unity editor download. As it's downloaded, so drag it to the Unity assets, import. Now go to image target, select the database. Now as you can see this error, go to console and click clear. Now right click on image target, click on create empty. Now right click on game object, go to UI and select canvas. Right click on canvas, go to UI, click image. Now right click on image, click on UI. Click on button. We need two buttons, one to move next and one for previous. Right click on image, go to UI, add another button. Now go to canvas, change the render mode to world space. Drag AR camera to the event camera. And change the positions to 0, x0, y0, to reduce its width and height. Now click on image, click here and stretch it. Now write 0, 0, 0, 0. Now go to button, reduce its height. We want one button on right and one button on left, so clicking on button, and we want it to on right, so clicking on right, and same, and write 0 here and do the same for button 1. Reduce its width and height. See. Now click here and we want it to be shown on the left side, so click on left and do it 0. Now there look alright. Now go to canvas and rotate its x axis 90 degree. Now it's fixed on the image. Now go to image, delete this component, add a component, sprite renderer. Now in order to display images, we need to put them in the resources folder. So now I'm dragging that images here. Now dragging these images into the resources folder. Now select these images, go to default, texture type, click on sprite 2D and UI, click apply. Now I am going to import a script. We will provide this script in the description of this video. You can download it from here. Import it. Opening it. You have to write the name of images in new string. We have named the images A, B, and C. As you can see here, A, B, and C. If you want to show more images, you will just add them in the same pattern in this string. Now going back to Unity, go to assets folder. Dragging this script on image. Now naming this button next. Name it as previous button. Now drag the next button here and previous button here. Now importing the arrow image to design next and previous button. This is the image which I selected. Import it here. Click the texture type and select 2D sprite and UI. Click apply. Now select both buttons and drag it to the source image. Check the preserve aspect. Now we have to rotate this button. Click on the next button and change the Z axis to 180. Now it's rotated. Now extend the next and previous button and delete text. And drag the first image we want to display on sprite. Now click on image, change its scale to 2, 2, and 2. Now move this button close to the image. Same with this button. By clicking the next button, we want to show the next image. So click on next, add, drag image here, function, slideshow, next. Now repeat the process for previous button. Click on add. Now drag the image here, click on no function, slideshow, click previous. Now we don't want to show this previous button on the first image, so click on previous button and uncheck it. Now go to file, build settings, click on add open scene, go to player setting, write your company name, product name, variant number. You can add the icon here. By default Unity icon will be shown here. I don't want to add an icon because I am just doing it for the test purpose. Go to other settings, drag down, change the package name, company, company. uncheck x86, uncheck Android TV compatibility, drag down, change main stripping level to high, drag down, go to XR setting and make sure vuforia augmented reality is selected. Now make sure your mobile phone is connected, click on build and run. Now name it. And save it. Now wait for it. It will create an app in your mobile phone. Opening that app. As you can see, it's perfect. If you like this video, so please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. God bless you all.